Alright, Shalom. Start first by giving all praise and glories unto Yahweh, Ba'ashim, Yahushai, Ba'ashim, Harakah Kodash. Double honors to the apostles and the elders at the great millstone. And greetings, salutations, and blessings, and much love unto the elect. Shalom. Alright, got another movie here. Weaned with Milk movie. Similar to the movie, The Book of Eli. But this one is one of those classic truth movies, in my opinion. Must-watch movie. As Book of Eli and some of the other movies I've featured so far on here, must-watch movie, okay? Pretty self-explanatory, but I will read the... This is the movie here, The Road, okay? But I'll read the premise of the movie. It says, America is a grim, gray, shadowy shadow of itself after a catastrophe. And, you know, biblically, we know there's something big coming, that there's catastrophe coming to the earth, okay? But they're not saying what it is directly in the movie. You know, it's just what happens to the world, okay? It says, particularly America. It says, a man played by Viggo Mortensen and his young son, Cody Smith McPhee, wandered through this post-apocalyptic world, trying to keep the dream of civilization alive. Okay, and it's beautiful the perspective that they take and what they show in the world. Also, you know, these certain TV shows that come out around this time is similar to without the zombies, of course, of The Walking Dead. Just like the first season, it just kind of throws you into this post-apocalyptic world. It looks similar, but you know, but you can, as the show goes on, it looks like something major went down, and then they remind you that it's not all the catastrophe riddled or whatever, but this world is. And it's a lot of little key things in this movie, and scriptures will come to mind. Anyway, it says they journey toward the sea, surviving as best they can on what they can scavenge, and trying to avoid roving gangs of savage humans who will turn them into slaves or worse. Yeah, so that didn't give up the, spoiler, but I'm going to play the beginning, opening scene of the movie, and then pull scripture after that, so bear with me one moment. Okay, it's the cover of the movie. All right. Yeah, Charlize Theron, Viggo Mortensen, Cody Smith McPhee, and Robert Duvall. All right, let me pull up the clip now. I'll partially narrate as it goes on. Lord willing, you can hear the audio. I want to say this right quick. Beautiful opening scene, because what they do is they show you how bright and vivid the world is. Okay? And then the rest of the movie, you'll see how it plays out. Okay? It's not shot in this type of color. Put it that way. They said a real gray world, right? Wakes up, sees something going on outside. Tried the lamp, no power. All right. Why are you taking a bath? I'm not. I have to show this scene and make a point in this scene. He just started running the bath. She's like, why are you taking a bath? It's like the middle of the night. He goes, I'm not. What is he doing? He's filling the tub up with water. while there's still water. Because there's no power, and he can see that whatever's going on outside is all out chaos, and they're going to need some water. It's a smart thing to think of, okay? To have water. And you see, she's holding her stomach. She's pregnant at this point, okay? That's outside. You can hear the chaos outside. Him dreaming, okay? That's the boy now. The baby in her stomach now. Just an earthquake. Just an earthquake. You tell the son, relax. It's okay. It's just an earthquake. Because we know the scriptures talk explicitly about earthquakes, man. You know, being in these last days. And then and you got to imagine it'll be even worse in the time to come. And throughout this movie, which, you know, when you watch it, you'll notice that there's earthquakes throughout the whole movie. It's not like just one big earthquake. They're just throughout the movie. Okay, I'll keep playing it. Actually, let me see if I can fix this audio. Bear with me a moment. Gotta say this, if any of you brothers or sisters, whoever that have watched this movie, if you haven't felt an earthquake, you know, we recently had here on the West Coast, Nevada, California, we recently had earthquakes, and growing up on the West Coast, I've had a lot of I've been in quite a few earthquakes, a couple major ones as well, and you know there's a higher power, you know there's a Most High. Because of it, it's not just, it's something much more powerful and heavy in the earth, okay, that you can feel. You can feel the power on that high level of an earthquake. All right, I'll let the movie play. Say this, he said he hadn't kept calendar in many years. It takes stamina to keep calendar, okay, to count the days and so on and so forth. Well, the Most High gave us a natural calendar, all right? The sun, you know, being a smaller level of the days, okay? The moon being of the weeks and the months, and the seasons themselves, if you know them. The unmistakable season is winter, okay? Where the reset happens, okay? And then after the winter is the birth season, all the way spring, summer, fall, back to the winter, okay? So you can kind of keep it that way, but in a world the sun has been blotted out where they don't really have bright sun or anything like that, and it's just gray, it's hard to keep that. It's hard to keep it. There's no real, you can't get a sense of when the seasons are, okay? He said the world is gray and becoming grayer as the world dies. All right, keep playing the movie.
No animals have survived. No crops are long gone.
What is that talking about? No animals.
Soon all the trees in the world.
No animals and no crops. All the animals have died and no crops. That's famine, man. Famine. Scripture speaks explicitly about the famine. All right? The roads are with people carrying refugees carrying cars. They're just moving around trying to find the best place to hold up, but they don't really have anywhere to stay. Just moving around. He said, and gangs, right? And all of them are looking for food. All right? This is coming, all right? Or some version of this is coming to the world that you know, all right? Let them implement that chip and you decide not to take the chip, you're going to starve. Let the government get shut down with no answers, what you going to do? All right? You got to start putting these scenarios into effect, all right? Can't let that slide. What was he what did he have in his hand? He had looked like grasshoppers and bugs, right? But if you look closely at the ones, like when I was watching the movie, when I recorded this scene, they were lawful bugs, creeping things as they're described in the scriptures, okay? But they were the lawful ones. When you read which ones are lawful, it's the ones with the legs, man, with the legs that go above the body, above the feet. Okay, not just the little legs that go down. It's a certain one that you can eat. Okay? And the scriptures describe them. Like here in Vegas, all the different locusts that are around, right? Those are lawful. Grasshoppers are lawful. Okay? You got to know which ones you can and you can't. And he figured out which ones you can. All right? Continuing in the movie.
Within a year, there were fires on the ridges. Chanting.
In a year, there were fires on the ridges and deranged chantings. Then they show a scripture. Okay, behold the valley of slaughter, right? Jeremiah 19:6, I believe that is. What do you think those chantings are? Call all your Ha'obashim Yahushai. First thing I thought of, first thing came to my spirit. Okay? Those are the chantings that'll happen. It's not Allah, Allah, whatever they say. It's none of that. It's the men of the Lord captive in America that are waking up, calling out to the Heavenly Father to be delivered, man. Calling out to the Heavenly Father in acknowledgement of his day is here. The day that he sends his son back is here. Alright? First thing that I thought of.
There's been cannibalism.
Cannibalism
is the great fear.
food and the cold and the shoes, right? But look at that. If you look closely right there, what's that? That's money on the ground. Meaningless. Money right there on the ground, and it means nothing. Because the economy is going to collapse, as the scriptures say also. All right? Now, am I going to pull every scripture pertaining to this one scene? No. So I'm kind of mentioning some things now. There's a few scriptures I do have that I want to pull. But particularly, you know, I'm just calling out these things as I'm seeing them, as they're coming to my spirit, coming to mind. All right? Money, lots of money. All I know is that God is my warrant, and if there or something to this effect, he said, if he is not the voice of God, then God never spoke. And what is it about? When you watch the overall theme of this movie, the father with his son, it's about sacrifice, man. Not burning animals or anything like that. It's about what you give up. Okay? That's the theme I got this last time I watched it. There's a lot of other themes that, you know, you can pull them out, leave them in the comment board, whatever you want to do. But for me, the overall theme was sacrifice. What are you willing to give up for your children? To earn your salvation, what are you willing to give up? People are eating. People are killing themselves in this movie, okay? Suicide is big. You know, cannibalism is big. What are you willing to sacrifice? They're eating bugs, lawful bugs, by the way, but they're eating bugs to survive. Going days without food. Okay? So now I'm going to just pull script because I believe it's the end of the clip anyway. Yeah, end of the clip. Alright, so let me pull some scripts now. Alright, first one I'm pulling is Amos chapter 8. It says, and it shall come to pass that in that day, saith the Lord power Yahweh, that I will cause the sun to go down at noon, and I will darken the earth in the clear day. Yeah, the beginning of the movie, they show bright and beautiful scenes of how the world, as we know it today, here in America anyway, we know it to be a bright and colorful place. But when the day of the Lord kicks off, it was all gray. Okay? All just gray. The whole movie, except for the flashbacks in this movie, are just gray. Like a gray themed color. There's no brightness in that day. Okay? It says, verse 10, and I will turn your feasts into mourning, all your songs into lamentation, and I will bring up sackcloth upon all your loins. What is sackcloth? It's a garment of mourning. It's a time of mourning. Okay? When you watch the clothing in this movie, they had jackets, they had pants and whatever else, but it all appeared as sackcloth, clothes of mourning. Nothing really bright and vibrant, you know, something that catches the breeze. It's none of that. It was just cold. Okay, it says, and baldness upon every head. Yeah, because usually you pulled out your hair, and you know, when you're vexed or when you're mourning. Okay, but also at the end of your life is when your hair usually falls out. Okay, so it's the end of life as they knew it. Okay, it says, upon every head, it says, and I will make it as the morning of an only son, and the end thereof as a bitter day. Okay, as a bitter day, and this movie is very bitter. You know, if you have children and you watch this and you see what the father goes through for his son in this movie, it really makes you check yourself on the inside. What are you willing to do and give up to make the situation as best you can? Like the scriptures say, woe unto them that give suck in those days. Okay? You have young children in those days, man, it's going to be hard. It's not going to be an easy thing, and this movie is a clear reminder of how difficult it could be. Okay? Let me keep going. It says, behold, the days come that the Lord Yahweh, saith the Lord Yahweh, that I will send a famine in the land. Now, there's other places where it talks about famine, lack of bread, which is the theme in this movie. But the number one theme that you'll start noticing after sacrifice is there's no wisdom, knowledge, and understanding in the land. Okay, which it says, send a famine in the land, not a famine of bread or nor thirst for water, but of hearing the word of the Lord. So there's no understanding about the times that we'll be in. And that's what you'll notice in the movie. There's no one, if there's anyone in the movie, it's them. And they're void of proper understanding. But they do little things like they ate the lawful bugs. They wasn't eating cannibalism, because cannibalism is against the scriptures. Though when people get hungry, they're going to turn to eating their children and eating people. Okay? Prevalent theme in this movie. He said cannibalism is the great fear. Okay? That's the number one thing you're afraid of. Of being eaten. People so hungry that they kill you to eat. And they drive that theme home in this movie. You think it was a theme in the Book of Eli when they go to the house, hey, want some meat? They're wondering like, oh shit, they're eating people. You know, they had all them graves in the back. They had the trap front door. They were eating, right? Well, in this movie, they even talk about not eating people, because people are getting eaten left and right in this movie, all right? Anyway, but here's where it really seems like they took this direct scripture and put it into the movie. Verse 12, it says, and they shall wander from sea to sea. They were going south toward the sea. It says, and from the north even to the east, they shall run to and fro to seek the word of the Lord and shall not find it. Okay, they're going to seek the word of the Lord and shall not find it. In that day shall the fair virgins and young men faint for thirst. Okay? Thirst for wisdom, rivers of living water. Okay? They're fainting for that and for lack of actual physical bread and water. All right? Go to another scripture right quick. Bear with me. Classic scriptures. 2 Exodus 15. I'm going to start at verse 5. It says, behold, saith the Lord Yahweh, I will bring plagues upon the world. The sword, which is the killing instrument. Okay? Those gangs that they show in the movie, they had killing instruments. Okay? The sword, famine, death, and destruction. Right? Famine, lack of food. Okay? I showed you the lack of the word of the Lord. Spiritual food, if you will. And now there's actual famine. Because not everybody's spiritual enough to understand the lack of the word of the Lord being food. But you're going to know when there's no food in the streets. When McDonald's is closed and all the little crap they got in there is closed. And all these other food places are closed. No grocery stores. Walmarts or concentration camps doing martial law. Like all this stuff is going crazy out here. All right. Death and destruction. People are dying in this movie left and right. It says, for wickedness have exceedingly polluted the whole earth, and their hurtful works are fulfilled. Okay? Therefore, saith the Lord Yahweh, I will hold my tongue no more as touching their wickedness, by bringing the earthquakes and different chaotic destruction to people. All right? Which they profanely commit, neither will I suffer them in those things in which they wickedly exercise themselves. Behold, the innocent and righteous blood crieth unto me. That's the chanting at the ridges and that they were talking about. Okay? And the souls of the just complain continually. Okay? Let me jump down some. And I'll get to some other good parts. And you know, you could say it was from missiles or whatever, but when the missiles hit here in America, there's not going to be an inhabitant anywhere. So that doesn't directly line up, but you know how Hollywood is. They're never going to give you the full skinny on what's actually going on in the proper context and situation. But these movies are still good and entertaining. Verse 14 says, "Woe to the world and them that dwell therein. Okay, for the sword and their destruction draw nigh, and one people shall stand up to fight against another with swords in their hands. For there shall be sedition among men." And you're going to see clear sedition in this movie, man. I mean, the sedition is, there's gangs, but everybody that's not in your known gang is man, is your enemy. At one point, Robert Duvall's character says, "I don't have anything. I don't have any food or nothing." He said, "Man, we don't want your food. We're not robbers." But he was so used to that, that he just thought that was the way the world was going to be. The way, you know, he just thought everybody came upon him, that's what it was. Okay, it says, "And invading one another." So if you got food, if your cart has something, blankets or whatever in it, you know, fuel or whatever you may have found, they're going to rob that from you. Look what it says right here. "They shall not regard their kings nor princes, and the course of their actions shall stand in their power." And what power is that? If you have bullets and guns or a killing instrument, if you're stronger, guess what? You're going to have more power than everybody else in that day. Okay? And something they allude to in this movie is the fact that bullets are going to be scarce. Okay? Bullets are going to be scarce. Once the real chaos hits the streets and all of that's gone, and one day Esau's going to run out of bullets, man. One day people going to run out of bullets. No matter what, they're going to run out of these bullets. Okay? It says, "A man shall desire to go into a city and shall not be able." That's the martial law. As well as certain reasons why, like, a bridge may be out or whatever, you can't get across it. Just different reasons why you can't travel freely like you're accustomed to. Okay? It says, "For their pride in the city, for because of their pride, the city shall be troubled, the houses shall be destroyed, and men shall be afraid. And a man shall have no pity upon his neighbor, but shall destroy their houses with the sword and spoil their goods because of the lack of bread and for great tribulation." And that's the recurring theme within this movie. Everything is about food. Everything is about spoiling the next person for some food. Okay? Excellent movie. Excellent movie. Let's see what else we got. Alright, Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 53. It says, "And thou shalt eat the fruit of thine own body, the flesh of thy sons and of thy daughters, which the Lord power have given thee, in the siege and in the straitness, wherein thine enemies shall distress thee." And that's what's going to happen, man. Cannibalism. That scripture is about cannibalism right there. The recurring theme of this movie, cannibalism is the great fear, is what he said. And the whole time you'll see people having cities, they'll have heads, they'll see blood, like, look like fresh blood on the ground. They're like, "Oh, this fresh blood, is somebody is here." They're always looking ahead to see if they should get closer to a certain place, to a certain house or whatever. Go in there and check it for food, if it's abandoned or not. All kinds of stuff in this movie, man. It's a beautiful movie. Beautiful movie, okay? Reminds you of the theme of the world to come, man. This world that we live in now, it's spoiling you, man. It's making you believe that everything's going to be okay. Most of you peons out there, and I'm talking about you everyday Americans and people across the world that have no clue about what's coming, that don't hear the words of the prophets, don't recognize the prophets on the street, don't understand the message of the prophets. It's telling you that the Lord is coming back, but the world will be, as we know it, will be destroyed. Meaning the ways of the world, as we know it, will be destroyed, not the earth itself. So for all these things going on, man, there's something happening big, okay? Something big going down. All right, and Yahweh Bashim Yahushar, the Lord and His only begotten Son, they're not playing. They're not playing. The message of the Bible is clear. Bad times are coming. Evil shall increase upon the earth. Okay, it's gonna be a very bad time. But His servants shall eat. The scriptures also say, you know, because they did find an underground bunker in the movie that had lots of food and. You know, they had power for a moment, but they had food in there. In a warm place, they went in the house and boiled water and took baths and cleaned up. And, you know, But it was a, man, must-watch movie. I'm actually in it right there, man. This is a must-watch movie. If you're in the truth, this is worth it. You're going to find so many spiritual things within this movie about the things we read about in the scriptures. They clearly were reading the scriptures, making this movie, taking references of certain scriptures out of this movie. So anyway, Lord willing, this was edifying. So I'd like to give all praise and glory unto Yahweh, Bashim, Yahushai, Bashim, Marakakwash, to belong to the apostles and the elders at the great millstone. Greetings, salutations, and blessings unto the elect. Shalom to the next one.